Next is select count star from hr.employees. This count function, if you use star, that means it will count everything, all the records inside the table. Now let us run this command and we should see 107 as the output, and there you go. This command will give us all the records inside the table, the count of total records inside the table. But we also have another option in the count star, count, and then we have distinct department underscore ID. Let's take, we have a requirement where you want to count the distinct departments. That means the different unique departments inside the table. Then you will use this distinct keyword inside the count function. Now it gives me, there are total 11 departments, distinct department IDs inside the employees table. Let us check if we have any distinct employee last name. Select count. I'll just go with last name from hr.employees. We'll see the output for this command first. So this will give us total count of all the records, all the last names. That means we have 107 records inside the last name column. Now if I put distinct, I'm just curious, I want to see if there are employees whose last name is same. Now do you see 102? That means we have 5 employees whose last name is same, right? So that's how you count. You use the count function to differentiate the distinct or all the data set. So now this is one of the interview questions for freshers. How do you count the records inside the table? You use this count function, count star, to count the total number of records inside a table.